Name times for you. Hello everybody, it's Joshy Blogs. This is my review of A Winter's Daydream. This game is a visual novel. There's like no choices at all. It's just reading. That being said, I really enjoyed my time with it. So it's not really much of a game. It's just reading with pictures. You just go through it and you get to the end. There's a bunch of problems with the game. The biggest problem being that the save functionality, you can't just bookmark wherever you want. You have to there's auto saving, like checkpoints that occur throughout the game, but the game doesn't do a very good job of letting you know when you reach a checkpoint. In fact, as far as I can tell, it makes no attempt to let you know whatsoever. But usually, you can kind of tell where a scene ends and a new scene begins, and those scene endings are where, you know, sort of when you reach a new place or something, and those scene endings are save points or checkpoints where you can just quit and come back. There's nice music, very sentimental, sort of, I'd call it a beautiful story. Just like a nice, lovely family story. And there's some comedy, which landed pretty well with me. I found the humor pretty strong. And there's sort of this ridiculously meandering perspective where the main character just kind of like thinks about things and sort of like goes into like ridiculous detail about random things like the stars and the way a wall looks or the way his toe feels or something, and it's just and some orange that he's like peeling in an obscure sort of way, and the taste of the orange and the feeling of the orange as his teeth bite into the flesh of the orange, just in like ridiculous detail, which I think is maybe intentionally supposed to be a bit comedic, like it might be a little bit parody, I'm not sure, but it gets a little exhausting. Like it really bulks out the story a lot, and it's a lot. It's one of those things where I don't know. I think it's kind of like a. For me, I found it all ultimately very entertaining, and I'd call that a flaw in the writing, and of course there's flaws in the gameplay, and But all in all, I really enjoyed the game. And so despite everything, just because I love the story so much, I give this game a 9 out of 10. I was thinking about trying not to spoil the plot elements, but there's some magical transformations in the game. And the main idea of the game is what pulled me in and made me want to check it out. And I think I would have been less interested if I realized how cute the game wound up being. But it's a story where this is a mild spoiler. I would say, you know, if you want to play a good visual novel game that's sort of sweet and sentimental and a family story, you know, maybe go out and get it. But here's the very mild spoiler, which is basically just the plot of the game itself. So if you wanted to be surprised by the plot of the game, you could buy it without listening to this. But the plot is that his grandmother magically transforms into a teenager again. And so he's traveling around, he's the only one that knows, and he's traveling around with his teenage grandmother on a magical adventure. And it's just a very awkward situation. And I kind of thought it was going to be a little more ridiculous and like sort of twisted or fan service-y than it wound up being. But this is just like a very nice, very sweet, lovely story about a boy bonding with his grandmother on a magical adventure. Really cute story. Highly recommend it. Give it a 9 out of 10. Reluctant 9 out of 10. It's sort of a guilty pleasure because the story is just like so. It's so meandering. It's so like. It's always going off on like weird tangents and just It's very slow paced, but all in all, it's a lot. See, you can see here, like this whole bit here has nothing whatsoever to do with the story. Of course, it wouldn't snow in Tokyo. That would cause too many problems. It could interfere with the bus routes and the train schedules. Schools would be shut. Business meetings canceled. It's like, this has nothing to do with the story whatsoever. There's lots and lots of stuff like that throughout. And it's kind of entertaining to me. Like, it just makes me laugh how ridiculous this character is. I think this might be like an accidental humor. I think I'm laughing at the story, not with it. Although I can't quite tell. But that being said, I still enjoyed it. The pleasure is pleasure. I think this game is fun, and I think its mistakes are adorable, and the whole game is adorable. So yeah, I'm giving it a 9 out of 10. I'm a little embarrassed to be giving it such a positive review, but it was a beautiful story. It made me cry a few times at the end, in a very good way. And that's it. Winter's Daydream, great virtual novel, visual novel. It's kind of basic, all made by I think one person, and highly recommend it. That's all, folks. Winter's Daydream, 9 out of 10. There's no voice acting. You just gotta read it yourself, which I kind of prefer. I like to read it and do the voices. So in a way, it's more fun for me when I don't have the option of letting the voice actors do it for me. That's all. See y'all next time. You're my son, he said. No matter what happens, you'll do just fine. I have faith in you. At the time, I appreciated this vote of confidence, particularly when I had so little confidence in myself. Aww. I'd like to believe I'm capable of being self-sufficient now, but I still think about my father's words from time to time. His serious tone was quite unusual for my dad, who, despite being tall and broad-shouldered like a cop from a film noir... You're killing me. Alright. That's all, folks. Winter's Daydream, 9 out of 10. See y'all next time.